my rowing, it started out with competition rowing in the Faroe Islands with a traditional Faroese boat. After a while, maybe the second year, I started to get interested in ocean rowing. The first real trip that we made in ocean rowing was from the Faroe Islands to Shetland, which lasted for 6 days in a Faroese boat. And 18 miles from land, we had to stop. So it was a success in one way, because I knew at that time that, at that point, that I was a, quite a tough guy, and I could really row an ocean. My name is Livar Nysted. I am 41 years old. I come from a small village in the Faroe Islands, which is called Kvanasund. I'm married with Svana, and I have four daughters. And most of my life I've been a sailor, a fisherman. And the last 10 years I've been working in construction there in the Faroe Islands. So that's basically my life.
Fjöllene standa ute, hold ut tame og surrande floen, svøypa i vinden, og lytla ljøenon fra svongon rauton. Ogjennar støyda se ut i ønsker.
Of course you have to be strong if you are going to go for 2 months, 3 months maybe, some even row 5 months. And you do that for, you know, 12 hours every day. So you have to be very strong. But the physical strength isn't, you know, that I think maybe 30% of it. It's more like a psychologically game, or it's very tough mentally, very tough mentally. If you're very tired, wet, cold, hungry, it takes so little for you to say something stupid to the next guy.
You told me I let a spark in you and it burst into a flame.
I've heard also stories about ocean rowers have started to fight about a banana. It takes very little for people to snap out there. I've been a sailor for so many years, you know, I left school very early and went on the ocean. So I've seen a lot of bad weather and stuff like that. So, you know, I wasn't surprised when we hit bad weather out there. So I was well prepared for that. So, yeah, I think you're just, you know, made out to be an ocean rower, or you're not. Oh, the ocean is something that I'm familiar with, so I know what it can do. I'm not scared of the ocean, but I respect it. I can see, you know, the ocean from my window. I can see the mountains from my window, and that makes people special, you know. Also, the extreme environment that we live here up in the North Atlantic, the weather, you know, sometimes is really horrendous. And that makes you something, you know, that shapes a person to something. You know, the ocean is beautiful for me, and just, you know, I can sit a whole day and just look at the waves, how they break, and that is enough for me. And, you know, go to bed happy.
It's pure and kind.
it's a bit you know, selfish to do it. I mean, I leave my family behind, 4 daughters and a wife.
To make it hurt and to fill the air.
And I live my dream while they are sitting back here scared. Svana is following us the whole way around across the ocean, and she knows when the weather is bad. So if it was the other way around, that she was on the ocean and I was back home, I think I would be scared. So I think sometimes it's more, you know, it's more difficult to be back home. And it is, you know, of course, and to do things that, you know, other people don't do. It's to test yourself. Of course, I did discuss it with my wife, but she was really excited about it also, so it was very easy to say yes.